1961, the lady you're about to see started a career in country music that is to this day yet to be surpassed, being the first lady ever to be nominated and win Entertainer of the Year. The first lady ever to have a movie to be made of her life. Ladies and gentlemen, make welcome one of the top 10 most admired women in the world, Loretta Lynn.
Show. Are you having a good time? Yeah. Hey, that's good. If I don't sing the song that you've come to hear tonight, holler it out. If I don't know it, you can get up and sing it yourself. That way, you'll be worth what you paid to get in here, see? Of course, I lie a whole lot.
Thank you.
What would you do if you knew how I was feeling? I wonder what you'd have to say. Afraid of the answers, I'm not taking any chances. I don't want to scare you away. Oh, so I lie. Oh, yes, I lie. That you won't see through. I don't like denying all the love that I've been hiding. I don't want to tell you the truth. Oh, so I lie. Oh, yes, I lie. There's a little boy give these to Jim. And where's he at, Jim? Oh, there he is with one of the Loretta Lynn t-shirts on. Ha, ha, ha. Thank you. Thank you for the roses, darling. They're beautiful. How'd you know yellow was my favorite color? Can I lay them right here? I think I'll dress up a stage, don't y'all? This next song is Lying, Cheating, Woman Chasing, Honky Tonkin', Whiskey Drinking, You Do That. On radio today, the singer sings another hurting song about a wife who sits and cries while her husband lays out all night long. When he finally staggers in, he begs the two boys, I've heard it all before. Guess who I got pictured in my mind? Yeah. It's lying, cheating, woman chasing, honky tonking, whiskey drinking you. Somebody must be taking notes while watching all the low down things you do. Who's the sorry so and so responsible for what I'm going through? It's lying, cheating, woman chasing, honky tonking. It's not hard to realize who this country's singer sings about. It's lying, cheating,
you. Thank you. You all notice I've already drank all of it, so I don't know if I can tell you anything or not. Would you hold my bottle while I tell a joke? Yeah. You notice it's empty, you know, I wouldn't trust you. I want to, first thing I want to do is thank you all very much for loving my little woman like I love her. And then I want to tell y'all a joke. Well, this ain't really a joke. It actually happened, you know. Well, maybe it didn't happen, but anyway. Yeah. This preacher preached down in our little church there at home at Hurricane Mills. You know, he never learned to drive a car, so he drove his bicycle to church every Sunday. And up on the handlebars, he had his little briefcase where he carried his, what he called text or, you know, script or whatever he's going to talk about that day. So he walked into church and he went up to Deacon. He said, Deacon, I don't know what in the world I'm going to do. He said, somebody stole my bicycle. And I don't know what I'm going to preach about because my script was on the handlebars and I don't know. Deacon told him, said, well, preach about the Ten Commandments. He said, everybody knows those, and said, you won't have a bit of trouble. And said, when you get up there, he said, you come to that part that says, thou shalt not steal. He said, you pound on that pulpit, you said, thou shalt not steal, you know, and really drive it home. And said, the guy that stole your bicycle might get to get a conscience and bring it back. So the preacher got up there and he delivered the sermon. He got back down and the deacon told him, he said, preacher, that's the best sermon that you've ever delivered since you've been in this church. He said, that was fantastic. He said, there's only one thing I don't understand. He said, when you come to that part that said, thou shalt not steal, he said, you didn't really drive it home like I told you. You know, it didn't pound on that pulpit. And the preacher said, well, I tell you, he said, when I got up there and I got into that one that said, thou shalt not commit adultery, I remember where I left my bicycle. Thank y'all, and thank you again for having me.
Where did we find him at? Well, we're lucky. Honey, you don't want that one. It's dead. Hey, Doolittle, come here. Doolittle, he's wanting to ask you something.
Did you ever build that house?
Honey.
I think you moved it 4 times, but I don't know if you ever built the house. That's the way it is.
No, we ain't got it built yet. Can't get Doolittle sober. Girls, listen, this is the truth. One time there was an old gal that come to my house. She had nerve enough to try to take Doolittle away from me. Let me tell you something. She didn't look too hot when she got there. She looked a whole lot worse when she left. She wasn't warm enough to take my man. Take my man. Women like you that
Thank you.
sometimes at night while you're fast asleep. I lie here alone in the darkness and weep. So sorry and sad, but that's part of the deal. When a tingle becomes a chill, loving you, I swear by the breath in my body, that's true. But a woman can't help the way that she feels when a tingle becomes a chill. It's Bobby. Continue, but for me it's all gone. Although I pretend, you just don't turn me on. The body performs, but the soul has no will. When a tingle becomes a chill, loving you, I swear by the breath in my body, that's true. Oh, but a woman can't help the way that she feels when a tingle becomes a chill. All of you that got to see the movie A Coal Miner's Daughter know that I was... Ho, ho, ho! Listen, West Virginia and Kentucky is so much alike, I just figured they're the same state. I don't know why they didn't make them that way. But anyway, all of you know what coal mining is in this part of the country. So I lived in the eastern part of Kentucky. Get it? Yeah. Oh, mercy. Wherever I lived, it was in the mountains, in the hills. But I got married very, very young. Well, I was really too young. I kind of walked out of my daddy's arms into my husband's arms. And when I was 7 months pregnant, we left Kentucky, moved all the way out to the state of Washington. And that's all the way across the United States, because we moved right up next to the Canadian border. And that's where we lived for 13 years. By the time I was 17, we had 4 kids. That's what I said, girls. Oh, but listen, they started coming in pairs. And I knew right then that I had to find out what was causing it. It was getting serious, because my old man wasn't telling me nothing, and he didn't allow nobody else to. And he ain't changed one bit today. Not one daggone bit. That's all right, girls. I found out what was causing it. It was in the water. I just up and moved away, but the babies just keep on coming. I don't know what's wrong. Jackie's seen in a discotheque doing a brand new dance. And what how social season should be glittering and gay. But here in Topeka, the rain is a fall. The faucet is a dripping and the kids are falling. One of them is toddling and one is a crawling. Honey, I was talking to the baby. Wait a minute, honey, the doorbell. Honey, could you stop at the market? Hello. Hello. Well, I'll be. The girls in New York City, they all march for women's lives. Better homes and garden shows, a modern way to live. The pill may change your world tomorrow, but meanwhile today. Here in Willie, the flies are buzzing. The dog is barking and the floor needs a scrubbing. One needs a spanking and one needs a hugging. Two's on the way. This is a song I should have found first. You wind me and dime me when I was your girl. Now the one that sings the loudest and the best, he's gonna be out there to talk to you. Okay, are you ready to sing? You can't be a vegan if your light don't shine. You ready to sing? Let me hear from you. You can beat that. Come on, loud. You wanna sing?
You can't be a vegan if your light don't shine. You can't be a vegan if your light don't shine. Yeah, that's a little light in all of us by God's design. You can't be a vegan if your light don't shine. Woo! You can't be a vegan if your light don't shine.
Oh,
you can't be a vegan if your light don't shine. Yeah, there's a little light in all of us by God's design. You can't be a vegan if your light don't shine. Thank you.
going to introduce the coal miners to you, whether you want to meet them or not. Really, it don't make any difference with them. They don't even know what color coal is. And furthermore,
Miss Lynn, we could care less.
They're in the wrong state to act like that, ain't they? They're in West Virginia, you know. That's the big thing is coal mining, just like Kentucky.
Why, Loretta, of course you know I'm only joking. Folks, my dad was a coal miner in Eastern Kentucky for 44 years, so I know a lot about coal.
He knows a lot about coal. He said his dad worked in the coal mines for 44 years. I bet he never was down in the mines. I'm talking about you.
I went inside a mine about 100 foot and said, that's enough for me.
That's about enough for me, too, I'll tell you. So.
You saying I didn't know anything about coal. I know a lot about coal. Matter of fact, I'm going to make a prediction here tonight.
Hey, you didn't know Gene Dixon's out there tonight with us? He's a good friend of mine.
Nothing like that. This is going to come true.
Dave.
Folks, I'm going to predict that coal is going to get us out of the mess that imported oil has us into today.
Right.
I'd say that just about says it all. I think that's fantastic. I wasn't aware of that. I'm sitting over here just marveling at what Dave is telling here. It's so full of information here, informative things that people probably didn't know they were going to get when they came out here to see the Loretta Lynn Show, getting on tape and all that, getting all this information. But that's, I'm glad to hear that because I missed that in the paper. But that is a good idea to show you what the body of this country can do once the people form together and get behind it and get after it, especially our senators and congressmen, what they can do about this energy crisis and fuel situation. That's right. That shows you what they can do once they get after it. Now all they got to do is figure out a way to get all these engines, men running on gas, a way to run off of hot air. Then... Then all they need to do is go to Washington, shove a pipeline up Congress, we get all the fuel we need. Then, see, now... These people know what I'm talking about. As a matter of fact, to get this program in full swing, our president made a statement today concerning this fact, the energy crisis. Now, I missed this in the paper, but it was there. Someone told me about it just before I walked on stage.
Oh, yeah.
He said that he could see the light at the end of the economic tunnel. But now, see, what he don't realize is that's a stockbroker down there with a flashlight on his hands and knees looking for food. See, he... But see, our president, I mean, I'm sure everybody knows him. President Ronald Ronald Reagan. To show you how enthusiastic he is with this issue, he left this morning to get this program in full swing. Left this morning for a tour of all the friendly nations.
That's
left
good.
About 6 o'clock.
That's good.
Of course, he got back about noon, so it didn't tie him up. Really.
Okay, you politicking more or you going to stop right there?
No, I'm going to quit right here. I could go on all day with these issues.
I know
issues.
You could. We know. I'm going to introduce everybody. On the banjo and also the harmonica, Durwood Edwards. Turn around here, Skinny.
But I'm glad to be here because I've been looking forward to coming here, and I just want to say that I was out there before the show selling a few records and met some beautiful people here. Yeah. And I have enjoyed myself. If we don't do nothing else here in Wheeling, I have enjoyed myself here in this beautiful town of yours, because I have been looking forward to coming here for some time now, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
And I have enjoyed myself immensely performing for you people in this beautiful complex, this wonderful establishment here. And we're not only here to do a few things, such as
what?
Put out a record and a videotape, but we're here to perform for you beautiful, marvelous people. Now, though some of you out there feel as I do this evening, we are here not only on behalf of Lloyd and Lee and her entire organization, but we are here on behalf of country music, our associates, all of our constituents,
that.
It was a brief moment, but I used a little of my influence. I hope you don't mind.
Did you kiss the policeman? Get back out here, Dennis. You ain't through. Did you kiss him? Do you know where you're at? You're in Wheeling, West Virginia. Better shape up.
Well, I'm glad to be here.
Why, well, used to be my bass player, friends, Dennis Digby. Monty Parkin sets at the piano. Lonnie Godfrey on the drums. Dave Thornhill has been with me for 14 years. He was the first one we hired. And from there, he started with the Coal Miners. Dave is my lead player and also the leader of the band. We could not do without you, Dave Thornhill. We love you. The first one that Dave hired is our steel guitar player, Bob Hemker. I don't think I have to tell you all how great our fiddle player is.
No, he'll tell you.
Where'd he get the microphone? His name is Zeke Dawson. He's fantastic. Donna, Lee, Deborah, and Ray. These kids are great, and they're going to prove it to you in just a few minutes. Right now, I'd like to introduce a little girl that's my daughter. And we call her Sissy. And the reason we call her Sissy, she's the real Sissy, is because when her daddy came to get us at the hospital, the nurse told him he had to have her named. And he had a few choice words for her, and he picked her up and left. 4 years later, we named Sissy. And we named her after my mama, Clara Marie, but we still call her Sissy. And that's all she is to us. Sissy, come out here, honey. She started singing with us about 4 months ago. This one is the baby before my twins come along. And she's still the biggest baby you have ever seen. When her daddy brought her down to Jackson, Tennessee and put her on stage, she stayed. She ain't stayed home since then, have you, honey? 4 months ago, we love her. She's my baby. Sissy.
I walk into the kitchen. just no use. I can't even get the blues. But then I fall asleep. I'm going under, but it's not too late. You wanna hurt me, but it's just no use. I can't even get the blues.
You know, each and every singer has that first big hit record that starts everything rolling for them. Loretta's career was exceptional in the fact that her first hit record also happened to be the very first song that she'd ever written. To sing that song for you, I'm a Honky Tonk Girl. Welcome back, the one and only Loretta Lynn.
I was 4 miles from here when I heard them introducing me. And we didn't get my hair done right, but what you see, friends, is what you're gonna get. It ain't gonna get no better the rest of the show either. I run. What, honey? Thank you. You're prejudiced, I can tell that right now. Thank you, honey. I appreciate that. Love you, too. Thank you. I love you all, too. Where is that girl? She said I was beautiful. I bet she's beautiful. Where you at, honey? Way in? You're up there. Well, holy smoke. You're high tonight, friends. That's all I have to say. Thank you. Everybody from Pennsylvania, that's good. When I went to the Grand Ole Opry for the first time and I sang I'm a Honky Tonk Girl, I stood in the wings of the old Ryman Auditorium. I watched a young lady get 3 standing ovations with a song called Crazy. This girl was 20 years ahead of her time. She was wearing the long gowns. She was working Vegas when that was unheard of for a country artist to do. She was killed in an airplane crash in 63. I still miss her today. Her name was Patsy Cline. I'd like to do a medley of some of her greatest hits, if y'all don't mind. Your class. that crew you had, and it still looks the same as when you gave it to her. The only thing different, the only thing new, I've got these little things. She's got you. Trick. We've come a long way, baby. asked me to stand here so I can take a picture. I'd like to say that this next song that I'm going to sing is one of my first, when I did my first religious album, I did this song in it. And it just happens to be one of my favorite songs that Don Gibson wrote, Where No One Stands Alone. Once I stood in the night with my head bowed low, in the darkness as black as the sea, and my heart was afraid, and I cried, oh Lord, don't hide your face from me. Hold my hand all the way, every hour of the day, from head to the grave, I know. Take my hand, let me stand where no one stands. King, I may live in a palace so tall, with great riches to call my own, but I don't have a thing in this whole wide world that's worth and being alone. Hold my hand all the way, every hour of the day, I'm here.
Make them like my daddy anymore.
I sure do wish you'd bless America again. You know the way you did way back when it all began. You really blessed her then, but we just kind of took it for granted. We never asked again. So hold her hand, God, and if she should stumble, please don't let her fall. But when you ain't got a lot of book learning, there's lots of things you just don't understand. One thing I do know, God, she's just like a mother to me. And all that I am or ever hope to be, I owe to you and I owe to her. Book learning, there's just lots of things you can't understand. One thing I do know, God, she's just like a mother to me. And all that I am or ever hope to be, I owe to you and I owe to her.
It's small and
from selling a heart. Daddy always managed to get the money somewhere.
We are so happy you can spend a very special evening with us tonight. Did you have a good time?
Yeah.